So I am going to explain the concept of plate tectonics with the help of this visualization, and we start right from the definition, and it includes that the concept of plate tectonics, it is a scientific theory that describes the large scale motions of Earth's lithosphere over the asthenosphere. This theory builds the concept of continental drift, and it is proved by the Earth's seafloor spreading and magnetic anomalies present over there. The main plates and their motions is all around, and as it is stated that the whole of the landmass long before today was jointed together, and it formed a mega continent, super continent called Pangaea, and which was separated into two land masses, the Eurasia and the Gondwanaland, and it created a mega ocean called the Panthalassa, and subsequently all these area got divided into many different parts, such as the North American plate, South American plate, African, Eurasian, Australian, Antarctican, Indian, and here you can see the Indian plate. Then the mountain explanation of plate boundary moving from its place explained by Sir Alfred Wegener in 1912. According to that, all continents were once glaciated. In present time, they are separated to each other and formed seven different continents, mega continents. Correlation of Africa and South America by Alfred Wegener, which was the proof for this plate tectonics concept. And these were the fossils. These are fossils of Mesosaurus have been found on both sides of South Atlantic and now where else in the world. Fossils remain of this and other organisms on the continents of Africa and South America appear to link these land masses during the late Paleozoic and early Mesozoic eras. And beyond these Mesosaurus dinosaur, these fossils, there are the evidences of these plants, many Glossopteris and Gangnopteris flora also. And the evidences cited by Alfred Wegener were including further evidence used by Wegener to support continental drift hypothesis. Mountains line up in northern hemisphere, North America, Europe, South America and Africa all fit together, and this induced fit hypothesis also supports the Alfred Wegener's theory of plate tectonics. Some fossils found on different continents and lithological aspects also support the concept of Alfred Wegener's theory of plate tectonics. Plate tectonics is a modern version of an old idea, plate boundaries. These are the sites of intense geological activities, which are mainly due to the movement of the plates. Each plate is bounded by a combination of three types of boundaries. New plate boundaries can be created in response to changes in the forces acting on these rigid slabs. The plate tectonics, there are different types. The plate boundaries, according to their motion, we can divide plate boundaries into three categories. The first one, divergent plate boundaries, these are also called constructive margins. Then the convergent plate boundaries, also called destructive margins. And third one is the transform fault boundaries, also called conservative margins. And here are the images for these different types of plate boundaries. First one, A part, is the divergent plate boundaries, where two plates move apart from each other. And the other one is the convergent plate boundaries, where one plate, the right one, is subducting beneath the other plate, that is the obducting plate. This is the type of B type, is the convergent plate boundary. And transform plate boundary is the C one, and where two plates slide past each other, one moving another side and there is the different side. The divergent plate boundaries is the mid-Atlantic ridge is an example. In this kind of plate boundary, plates move apart, resulting in upwelling of material from mantle to create new sea floor. Hence, new crust is being formed there. The mid-Atlantic ridge, which splits nearly the entire Atlantic Ocean north to south, is probably the best known example of a divergent plate boundary. Then convergent plate boundaries, these are those boundaries where plates move together, causing one of these slabs of lithosphere to be consumed in the mantle as it descends beneath an overriding plate. The 6,000 km plus journey of Indian landmass, Indian plate, before the its collision with Asia, Eurasian plate, about 40 to 50 million years ago. And hence, because one plate is being consumed another under the another plate, hence it is called destructive plate margin. There is the transform boundaries. You can see in this image. In this type of boundary, plates grind past each other without creating or destroying lithosphere. Hence, also called conservative plate margin, the San Andreas Fault Zone slices through 2/3 of the length of California. Along it, the Pacific plate has been grinding horizontally past the North American plate at an average rate of about 5 cm per year. And average, all of the continents move with a pace of average pace of 2.5 cm per year. How and why plates move? There is a big question. There are several reasons for this question, which include the formation of oceanic crust, oceanic topography, rate of motion, temperature difference, gravity difference. And the major reason for the movement of plates is the convection currents present in the mantle. Causes of plate motion include formation of oceanic crust. Crustal formation is a continuous process where new crusts are formed by pushing older one earlier and causes spreading of lithosphere. Then the oceanic topography. As the mid-oceanic ridges form from where new lithospheric plate originates are normally 2 to 4 km above the sea level, it may also be a reason. More causes include rate of motion. It is believed that since spreading of plates at ridge crest occur at rates ranging from 1 to 6 cm per year but are consumed at the rate of 5 to 15 cm per year at the oceanic trenches, the plates must move to maintain a balance between the two. Then the temperature difference. This is the main cause for the movement of plates. The cooling of the plates increases its density and it becomes heavy enough to sink back into the mantle. Thus, the difference in the heat flow values seem to be responsible for plate motion. Then, gravity difference. Mid-oceanic ridges are almost close to isostatic equilibrium, but trenches are marked by very strong negative gravity anomalies. The gravitational difference is believed to cause plate motion. Here in this image you can see oceanic plate is because of its heavy density, it is subducting over the continental plate. The plate tectonic model, this is of no use for us, seafloor spreading. Then the features or landforms associated with plate tectonics. This is the application of this plate tectonic concept. Continental versus oceanic collision zone. It creates subduction zone, deep sea trenches associated with it, volcanic arcs and andesitic volcanic rock. Then the continent versus continent collision. Granitic rocks, mountain building processes, no volcanism, no magmatic activities is the associated landform or features. Oceanic versus oceanic collision zone. As these are the dense and heavy gravity plates, these form deep sea trench associated and volcanic island arcs, basaltic volcanic rocks associated with them. Then divergent zone forms oceanic basaltic magma, spreading center mid-oceanic ridge, also continental granitic and East African rift zone is an example for this. These were the few features landforms associated with the plate tectonics. Thank you.